It's Keke, aka Shyfacediva. Thank you for joining me in the kitchen again. Today we're going to be doing a slow cooker beef stew. What you see here, I have a pound of beef stew meat and I have a pound of round steak. You can do either or. I'm going to be doing both. Okay, so what you're going to do first, I'm going to be adding some celery salt to it. The next thing I'm going to be adding is some black pepper. The next thing I'm going to add is some garlic powder. And last but not least is some onion powder. And custom this to your liking. You don't have to add the same seasons as I do. Okay, so once the seasoning is in there, I'm going to stir it up. Once I mix my seasonings in, I'm going to be adding 2 tablespoons of flour. Okay, so I'm going to stir it in and coat all the meat. The next thing I'm going to be doing is stir frying my meat in a stir fry pan. I'm not worrying about it if it's going to get through all the way done because it's going to finish cooking in the crock pot, okay? So all we're going to be doing is browning the stew meat, okay? And I put some oil in here so it should be nice and hot. So we're going to be cooking this until it gets nice and brown. Once your meat get brown on the outside, you just want to set this to the side and get out your slow cooker. Okay, the first thing I do with my crock pot, I like to spray it with non-stick spray just to help the dish won't stick after it's done. The next thing I'm going to be doing is adding a 14-ounce can of beef broth. I'm going to be adding an 8-ounce can of tomato sauce. Just going to give this a little stir. Next thing I'm going to do is add my meat that we browned. The next thing I'm going to add are my potatoes, and I cut them in cubes. This is about a pound of potatoes. After the potatoes, I'm going to add a cup and a half of carrots. After the carrots, I'm going to add 1 large onion. The last thing I'm going to do is take another 14-ounce can of beef broth, but this time I'm only going to pour half the can in there just to cover the meat and the vegetables. You want to save the other half for later on what we're going to do with it, okay? Okay, after you add your half a can of beef broth, you want to let it cook 10 to 11 hours total. You can actually cook it on 5 hours on high, but you just got to keep checking on it and see if everything nice and tender. It might cook faster. It depends on how much time you have. And I'm not going to add any more seasoning to it until it gets completely done, okay? I'll be back to finish up the stew. And it's actually done. And everything is nice and tender. Okay, so now we're going to be making this liquid thicker. The next thing I'm going to do is add 1/3 cup of flour. Then I'm going to take that beef broth from earlier and I'm going to add the rest of it to this flour. And I'm going to mix it in until it's nice and smooth. Next, I'm going to add that beef broth and flour mixture to the crock pot, and this is going to make our stew liquid thicker. And make sure your crock pot is on high, okay? So now we're going to let this simmer 15 to 20 minutes or until it thickens up. Okay, guys, it's been 20 minutes, and as you can see, the stew has thickened up nicely. And seasoned to taste, I added salt, pepper, seasoning salt, garlic powder, onion powder, and I just added a little bit of those. And you can add whatever season you like, and that will complete your stew. And I hope you guys enjoy this recipe. Thank you so much for watching, And I will see you in the next one.